Good morning.
Good morning, Tony.
Morning.
How are both of you holding up?
We're doing so well. How can you not be well when you're sitting by Jenny Ross talking to press around the world? It's awesome. Life is good, Tony.
I'm excited to talk to both of you. First of all, Jason, Christmas jars, I mean, this has now become a pretty big thing. You're the father of a whole new tradition.
Yeah, I know. This giant baby of a million people around the world that have read the book, and so many have taken part in the tradition. I'm sure a lot of people watching right now already know that this was inspired by a little tradition my family started 13, almost 14 long years ago. And it's so simple, America. Just take a jar, put it on your counter, fill it with spare change. It doesn't matter whether you start the tradition in January or July or today, right now. Fill that jar up and then find someone in your circle of influence, in your neighborhood, at church, at work, whatever, and with your family, give that jar of loose change away anonymously and see if it doesn't really change the way you think about the needs of other people during the holidays. That is the message of Christmas jars, that you can change a life with just one jar.
It is a very, very human story, and a very human thing to do. Is we're always looking for ways to help our neighbors, people in our families, and this is just a beautiful way. It's a wonderful sentiment. And you could pass it on.
Yeah, that's the idea, is if you get a jar this year, then, you know, be first in line next year to give a jar away. If people visit ChristmasJars.com and read some of the real life stories, they'll see just how this has started from a kind of a little grassroots movement and a few families that first year to now, as I said, thousands and thousands of people around the country, and even now spreading to other countries that are participating in the Christmas Jars movement.
Well, Jenny Ross, you are the star of Christmas Jars. Tell me a little bit about Hope.
So Hope is an aspiring news reporter, and she is going through a rough time. She sort of finds herself alone in the world, and after some unfortunate events, she finds a jar outside of her apartment filled with change. And this really sparks something inside of her to figure out who left this for her, and to figure out her own way of finding them and saying thank you through a news story.
When you auditioned for this, that had to have been a wonderful moment in your life to get this role.
Yeah, it's a funny story because it all happened so quickly for me. It was within a week and a half that I received the audition, went in, found out that I booked it, and packed up and moved to go film it. So it was very quick for me, which was a whirlwind, but it was really special getting to actually read the book and have the source material before I started filming something like this. It was really special.
Have you adopted this into your own life? Or are you doing Christmas jars?
Yeah, actually, my mom the other day was talking to me about the jar that she has going, and she picked who it's going to. So it's been really moving. And we had a screening of the film a few weeks ago, and after the film, I got to sit down and talk with quite a few people that received jars of their own, and they told me their stories about how much the Christmas Jar book and the movement really changed their family and how they've kept up with it. And it's been so cool, and it's really an honor to be a part of it.
And I love that you asked that question. No one has asked that. Of all the press we've done around the country, no one has said, do you have a jar?
Yeah.
So my heart went, oh no, this could be really bad. So I'm thrilled you asked that, Tony, and I'm thrilled that you have a jar on your counter. How cool is that, that Hope Jensen, the Hope from the book, has her own jar to give away? I love it.
You know, Jason, there's this whole category at the bookstore of Christmas stories, and you're in there like two or three times with your books. That's got to be a kick too, to be part of a specific genre like that.
Yeah, it's a genre that's really blown up over the last 20 years or so. Without naming names, there were some books a couple decades ago that everyone said, no one's ever going to read a Christmas novel. Like a novel just about a Christmas story will never work. But a few brave souls went out there with product again about 20 years ago and really changed the market for people like me. And it's an honor to go into a Barnes & Noble or your local bookstore somewhere and to see three or four different Christmas books. And who knows, maybe after November 4th, enough people will show up to see Christmas Jars that will go, hey, let's make another one. And maybe I'll get to work with Jenna Ross again.
Yeah, I know out here in Utah, people are looking really forward to seeing this at Fathom Events. I think it's sold out. And then, of course, it'll be on BYU TV as well. Jenny, how does it feel to be one of the, in that category too, in the category of Christmas movies?
It's really special. My family is actually, because I live in Canada, so we're going on a bit of a road trip up to the States to go see it on the big screen.
I love it.
Yeah, I'm very excited. My whole family's just really looking forward to seeing it.
And, you know, real quick, Tony, this is not a typical Christmas movie, and you know, you've seen it, so you know. We love Christmas movies. Mm-hmm. I bet Jenny is going to get booked, and so you are going to see so much Jenny Ross over the next few years, and I suspect in Christmas movies. But Christmas Jars has a little something extra, particularly mm-hmm. in the third act of the film, that I think people are really going to appreciate. And when you see it, you'll go, oh, so that's why they wanted to put this in theaters for one night. It's that good.
Exactly. We can't give away spoilers, but you have to see this movie. Again, you can catch it at Fathom Events. Go to their website and find a theater near you that's playing it. And then, of course, on BYU TV, they'll be streaming it on their platforms as well. Jenny and Jason, thank you so much for being part of our show, and Merry Christmas to you.
Thank you. Merry early Christmas to you, too.